So non-programmatic savings are all the energy efficiency that happens in the region outside of programs. So lots of folks do energy efficiency for lots of different reasons. And what we found is that there's a good number of people that don't take our incentive dollars to do that. So non-programmatic savings are essentially the quantification of all of that awesome effort and the energy efficient choices that the Northwest is making. It's funny because market movements and big energy efficiency trends that non-programmatic captures can feel very made up. They can seem, it's kind of like, well, you just sort of came up with a spreadsheet and collected some data, and it feels, doesn't feel real. What's interesting, though, is that because it's these big shifts in the market, that's very reliable. So, because it's spread out across the entire region, you've got a lot of reliability that's being built into it. It's a lot of movement has to happen for you to be able to capture it at that big level. And so when you're looking at it across the region, you're really able to come up with very reliable estimates. Non-programmatic savings are reliable savings. They're reliable because they're measuring the total market movement. When you have a big trend in energy efficiency, when you have, for instance, the current movement to LED lighting, you see that across the region and you see that very clearly. The signal comes out, very robustly. And so with our detailed data sets and with the, amazing knowledge that we have about the existing infrastructure, we're able to estimate these total market movements very reliably. It's a different way of getting to a similar outcome, which is, we tend to do a lot of measurement at the site level, and this is doing the same type of measurement, but using different data sources at the total market level. Non-programmatic savings are tricky to quantify. It's one of the beautiful things about having incentives and paying end users directly for energy efficiency is you know exactly where that efficiency is and where and what that efficiency is. When you haven't purchased it, you don't have that direct tie anymore. And so we need data. So there's a couple of different sources of data we use. One of the biggest sources is sales data. So when we understand what kind of sales are coming, what sales are happening in retail stores or through distributors, then we can understand what's going into the market. We also use a lot of NIA's building stock data. So when we understand what's already installed, and then we can develop models that essentially takes the new sales data and applies it into the stock. Now, what we know about the market is that a lot of people go out and they do these, energy efficient activities without getting our incentive dollars. So it's important that we capture those so that we're accurately accounting for what the power resource is. So we're accurately estimating, what the contribution of energy efficiency is to the region. That's the biggest reason. You don't want to estimate that you're going to have to build a power plant or obtain additional resources when, in fact, that's happening. You just didn't know about it. The energy efficiency is getting built. So that's reason number one. Reason number two is that you don't want to have program strategies that waste ratepayer dollar where energy efficiency is already happening. So if you don't need to be investing your dollars directly in that way, you shouldn't be. So the future of non-programmatic is that we're going to be quantifying a lot more markets and we're going to be doing a lot more market research. So the market research that we've done so far has shown much bigger savings than what we anticipated. Because of that, we're really trying to understand how that works in different markets. And by market, I mean, like the HVAC market or the non-residential lighting market. So we're kicking off a bunch of different research in a wide range of markets and figuring out, first of all, can we get the data? And second, when we are we able to estimate the savings? And once we've figured that out, we'll start releasing out, additional numbers and looking at, where are we seeing big market movements that are happening outside of programs and where we're not? Because that's really important information for our programs to have so that they can then refine their strategies. So energy efficiency is a power resource, but unlike other power resources, energy efficiency can be built by anybody. So anybody can kind of, you know, develop the power plant that, you know, fuels our future. Non-programmatic savings captures all of the energy efficiency that folks are doing that we aren't paying for directly. That energy efficiency is just as valuable, but it's most valuable when you know about it. The future of non-programmatic is that we're going to be hearing a lot about it. We are going to be tracking every market that we can get data on over the next year, so we'll be getting a lot more information. The estimates that we have are that this is going to become a bigger and bigger source of the region's energy efficiency.